It's very late. I think that's how I begin every Drosh and Shul also. And I'll begin by saying that the same way in Shul, the same rules, that it's okay if you fall asleep. The Maila here is I don't even see if you're sleeping. No talking. Same rules. Same
yes.
And to think about Kodesh Baruch, that's the same rules as in Shul. I want to begin our journey. The journey began officially, which I'll talk about in Derech that we just had. The journey began, of course, back in New York. For most of us, the blocks in Florida, some elements in Eretz Yisroel. The journey began long before that, a different place for all of us. But I really want to begin by giving a tremendous, tremendous Yashar Koach to Yitzchak Mordechai Feder, the journey fair.
Excuse me?
Really
the amount of
Mesiras Nefesh that was put into this, as you all know, this was a trip that was planned already for a while back. And it wasn't the Hashgacha at that time to go. And each time, the effort that was put in by Yitzchak Mordechai was something that really was l'malum and atava. And due to his efforts, due to Yitzchak Mordechai's efforts we hear, but it wasn't just Yitzchak Mordechai. Throughout the entire ordeal, meaning the failed attempts to come, and now, Baruch Hashem, our being here, it's all because of the shutzfus of Yitzchak Mordechai and Sarah and Yoni Melman. It's all mishpat of ours. Some of you that are new in the shul or have not been with us for a while, so you don't remember the Yoni and Sarah days, but it's always been part of the Mishpacha and always been close to us. And anything that we need to take place for us in Yerushalayim and here is because of Sarah and Yoni. The truth is that Sarah for many, many years has been begging me to do this. And there are different reasons why I was hesitating. And because of her constant badgering, stalking, all of that in a holy way, the way she does things, that's what we hear. And because of the keys that Sarah has, and Yoni has, with the terrain that we're now traveling on, we're able to do this and to feel comfortable and confident that we have kever that are looking after us, that are taking care of us, not that we're just at the mercy of the locals. So it's a very, very big, it's a very big mile for us, and I want to give you a big yashar koach. And the 80 sandwiches were actually homemade, so everybody appreciates. It's hard for me to communicate in this way, not being able to see everybody talking about fun. But I know who's here, and I'm able to imagine the faces, to think of the faces. We have a lot to learn. Generally, I don't like to do this thing on the bus. When I took a chevra to Poland a few years ago, I spent many hours a day doing this on the bus. I didn't feel that it was the right way to learn, but we had no choice over there. Over here, I was hoping that the time would be a little bit different, but it was the Hashgacha that we come now, and we're going to the Berditchev. At a time that's a bigger Yisroel, the time of the night that we're going to be there. So it's a Hashgacha practice. I guess I want to begin by telling everybody that there's a theme. there's a theme of the trip that we're on. And the theme is the tzaddik. The theme is the tzaddik. And we're going to be learning a lot. Can I understand their limitations of time? I prepared the booklet that you have is really around 1/10 of the material that I have sitting on my desk at home. But I, and my wife kept on telling me, this is ridiculous, I can't do this. So I kept on cutting it down to the 46, 47 pages that you have. And even that, I'm not sure that we're going to be able to cover much of it. I'll try as much as possible, as much as you can recital. But in addition to my talking, looking forward to hearing from many of you at different points along the way. That means impressions, memories, thoughts, the different sudas that we're going to have here, the different makamis that we're at, and on Shabbos, Yom HaShem, in Yerushalayim, to hear from you as much as possible. And I apologize in advance that my voice is the one, as always, that is being heard so much. But there's really a lot to talk about, there's a lot to say. So I know that you're tired. We're going to begin a little bit because we can't come to the scene of Kedushas Levi without making some achanas. To begin, let me just say, there's a sentence that's found in the Kutei Eitzes. We're going to come to Berditchev by way of Rabbi Nachman, and we'll talk about the Berditchev. In the Kutei Eitzes, the Loshon is HaTzadik HaEmes UHaPe'er VaHayoyfi Shal Kol HaOlam Kulay. The true Tzadik, Rabbi Nachman said, is the Pe'er. It's the splendor, the Pe'er, the pride, and the splendor, and the Yofi, and the beauty. Shal Kol HaOlam Kulay, of the entire world. And the tzaddik, who is the pe'er, who is the splendor and the beauty of the world, is the balabayis of the entire world. Now every one of you here knows that even though Rabbi Nachman was talking about all tzaddikim, but when he used the word pe'er, as we've learned in the shul over the years, that pe'er, he was speaking more specifically about that tzaddik who he referred to as the pe'er, as the most beautiful, as the beauty of all of the tzaddikim, was Reb Levi Yitzchak from Berditchev, Shlusel Nival Kol Yisrael. He was the Pe'er. Rabbi Nachman spoke about him as the tefillin Shoraish, the Pe'er. When Reb Levi Yitzchak was Nifter, Rabbi Nachman told everybody all around should check their tefillin. Thousands and thousands of Jews saw that after Rabbi Levi Yitzchak was Nifter, that the tefillin, which is called the Pe'er, our Pe'er, that the tefillin were possible. So, all tzaddikim are pe'er, but befrat, Reb Levi Yitzchak from Berditchev is the pe'er. If you look in the booklet that you have, on page 1, where it says, Ma'ase Mirav Uben Yochid, which is the 8th Ma'ase, the Sipur Ma'ase. 8th Ma'ase and the Sipur Ma'ase. Now, a number of you have been to Uman and Mezhbiz and to Berditchev and the Kermis Kedoshim here. And when it didn't work out at the airport in New York, those who have been on this trip were nodding their heads, and we were talking about it, and it was something that was expected. The Menias, the obstacles that are in the path of going to the tzaddik is what I want to begin talking about. I expected that there would be something. I didn't know what, and I certainly had no hand in arranging for that. But the derech to the tzaddik, which we're on right now, which we began yesterday, the derech, the path that leads to the tzaddik, is itself very, very important. And we need to understand why there are menias. And a chiddush when it comes to, I believe, it's like from Berditchev. Because Berditchev revealed to us, and that's what we're going to be learning, little bit on the way now. Reb Levi Yitzchak from Berditchev revealed the mystery of Kvitzas Haderech, the site of Kvitzas Haderech. Now I know that nobody here feels that we made a Kvitzas Haderech so far. But we're going to learn from Reb Levi Yitzchak from Berditchev that there's a deeper meaning to the term Kvitzas Haderech. It means something much more than fast space travel. It means something much, much more than that. But in order to understand, everybody look inside. Again, it's with the understanding that it's hard at this time of the morning of the night, but we're still a little bit on New York time. To try to follow inside, but it's important. Look on the first page. Ma'isim Yirav Ben Yochid. This is from the Sipuri Ma'isis, the eighth story of the Sipuri Ma'isis of Rabbi Nachman. I'll read it very quickly. We could spend the rest of the trip from now until after Shabbos explaining, interpreting, and talking about the Ma'isa, but I think even on a very, very simple level, it's the right way to begin our journey. Ma'isa b'rav echad shlohayu l'bagu. Menachem, as you know, more towards the end of his life, began to tell stories. And he told the story, Ma'isa b'rav echad, there was a certain rav, who didn't have any children, didn't have sons. And finally he had a ben yochid, he had his only son. He raised him, and he married him off. And this son would sit by Aliyah someplace upstairs, somewhere in the house, in isolation. And he was able to learn peace the way it was in those days by the wealthy fathers-in-law. He was able to learn there. And he was always learning, and he was always davening. But he always felt, I guess like me and you growing up, he always felt that with the learning that he was doing and the davening that he was doing, he always felt that there was chosel lo yezich chisar, that there was something that was always missing. And he didn't know what it was that was missing. Everything looked good. He was obviously very well taken care of. Didn't have to worry about money. He was learning and davening all the time, but there was always a chisar. He didn't know what it was. I'm not going to ask you to raise your hands together with me, whoever can identify with that. He was davening and he was learning, but he didn't taste a tam. He didn't have a tam. In all of his learning and all of his davening, he wasn't able to taste the tam of the learning and the davening. And as it's very, very good to do, to have a close friend or two. He didn't go and tell his father. We're told in the Ma'aseh that he went and he spoke to two Anashim B'nei HaNa'ura. Sounds like two of his chaver. And he spoke to them. V'nosn lo Eitz. And the two chaverim had an Eitz. It's interesting, just to take note, that the Eitzah did not come from the institution. The Eitzah did not come from the principal, from the Rosh Hashiva. The Eitzah didn't come from the board, and it didn't even come from his parents. The Eitzah came from two Na'arim Chaverim, Shnei Anashim B'nei HaNa'urim. Na'urim, if you know, of course, means a lashon of being awake. Na'ar is a lashon of his Isairus. He had two friends that Baruch Hashem were wakeful Jews who were awake. The Noshon Lo Yitzah, and they gave him an Eitzah. She Yisroel Lo Yitzah Tzadik. The Eitzah was that he should travel to the Tzadik. Voice Ben Hanal Osa Mitzvah Shabbal Yod Lopchinas Mor Hakot. Here Rabbi Nachman reveals the mystery of the small luminary that is going to bask in the light of the great luminary. there are many who believe that this story is hinting to the relationship between Rabbi Nosson and Rabbi Nachman. And how Rabbi Nachman was longing for Rabbi Nosson to come to him. The student, the Talmud, is the Mo'ar HaKotan, is the small luminary. Like the Gemara tells us, Moshe Rabbeinu was the sun, and Yehoshua was the moon. Many of you learned the sixth Torah, look at the Maran, Baki Biratzo, Baki B'Shoiv, and you recall the description of Rabbi Nachman and the relationship between the Rebbe and the Talmud, Moshe Rabbeinu, the sun, and Yehoshua, the moon. The Mo'ar HaGodol, the Mo'ar HaKotan. So we're told in the story that this sun, the son of the Rav, he was able to merit to be prepared to be on that level of being the Mo'ar HaKotan, of being the moon, to receive the light of the Tzaddik. He was obviously a very great person, and that's why he felt the longing and the emptiness. V'holach oisa ha-ben yochid, so the ben yochid went v'siper lo'oviv, and he told his father, he told his father the truth, that with all of his learning, with all of his davening, he doesn't feel a tam. He just doesn't feel the taste. And it's missing in his life. And he doesn't know why. The moon can't breathe, the moon can't live without the light of the sun. And he wants to go to the tzaddik. The heishiv le'aviv, and his father told him, Eich ata bolin soye'elav, le'ata lamdan yoyisim yimen. What do you, want to go to that malayfis, to that wonder worker, to the rabbi, to the rebbe, to the tzaddik? You're a bigger lamdan than he is. You're a bigger Talmud Chacham than he is. U'meyuchas yoyisim, and you're a bigger yachsin. He had bigger yichas than this so-called tzad. Loinol acholin sorei love. It's not becoming for you. It's not proper for you. It's not right for you to go to him. Kalech miderech zoi. Kalech miderech zoi. Stop with this. Kalech miderech zoi. Drop it. Give this up. Stop talking about it. And as it often happens, that the people who love you and want what's best for you sometimes prevent you from taking the journey that you need to, because they think it's in your best interests not to go. It's a good boy. He went back to learning. But he couldn't help it. He still felt empty. And he went to speak to the guys again. He went to speak to the chevra. And they told him that, listen, we have no other eitzah. This is what you need. They felt that he's the Mo'ar HaKotan, and that he needs to go to the Mo'ar HaGol to receive light. And therefore they said, you have to go to the tzaddik. He went again to his father. But his father prevented him from going. And so it was a number of times. But the son felt that he was empty. To fill the emptiness of his life. He didn't know what it was that was causing him to feel that way. But this time he went to his father, he begged his father. His father didn't have a choice at this point. And his father agreed, but only if he could go with him. He didn't want to allow him to travel by himself. Machzim Shahir ben Yochid, he was an only son. So the father says, you're going to see, I'm going with you. And I will show you that there's nothing to this son. All that you hear about him, all the talk, there's nothing. And they went into the Merkava, which itself is a very significant word in the story, but again, there's no time to go into that right now. And they went. Omli Oviv, and his father said, like all chaykrim and all skeptics, the father said, Bazeh anase. We're going to make a test. I'm going to make a test as far as this journey that you're determined to take to the so-called tzaddik. I'm going to set up a test. Bazeh anase. Im yisnahi kisei there. If the trip goes kisei there, meaning if you make a connecting flight. That's my test to see if you're awake. Okay. If the trip goes in Yisnaheik Kiseder, if the journey will take place and it will be Kiseder, then the Rav says, the father, Humana Shemai, then that will be a proof that if everything goes well, you'll hear how a Misnagid thinks. If everything goes just right, if there are no Maniyas, if everything goes right, that's a simon from Shemaim that it's right, that it's good. That's the mahalach of a misnagel. I'm just warning you, when I'm in this place, I don't hold back anything. So, im yisnaik yaseidahu min Shemaim. If everything works out and everybody shows up on time and the connecting flight is made, and all the suitcases are there, and everything is kaseder, the Rav says, the father says, Humen HaShemayim. Then it's a simon from Shemayim. V'im lav, but if not, if there are going to be difficulties, obstacles along the way, then it's a proof that it's Einam in HaShemayim. Menachzer, and we're not going to continue. If we find that the trip doesn't go well, there are bumps along the way, we're going back. They came to a little bridge. Do I have to tell you what that's referring to? It's referring to the nisyanis of this world. Of kol ha'olam kula gesher tzadmai. The entire world being a bridge. They came to a small bridge. And in this world, there are casualties, there are difficulties. There are many who cannot make it over the bridge intact. And sure enough, by the little bridge, the nofal sus echad, one of the horses, fell. Vahamerkova nizhavcha, and the chariot, the wagon, turned over. A person's mazel, just when they think that they're doing the right thing, just when they think they're going to the tzaddik and they're following the advice of those who have true Yiras Shamayim, and they're going to the tzaddik, things begin to go the other way. And the Merkava nishapcha, mamish, things turn upside down. Ukemat nidbu, and it fell by the water, and they almost drowned. Omloy aviv, his father said to him, that's it. Re'eish and misnahi kesedah. You see for yourself, don't you see? Ein misnahi kesedah. The trip is not going right. It's not kesedah. It's not in the right order. Mr. Shemot Shabbos, and Yerushalayim will talk about a Torah from Rabbi Nachman of things that are kesedah and shaloi kesedah. The Pashas Bahalois of Mr. Shabbos. So you see that it's Einam Esnahi kesedah. Things are not kesedah. Vein HaNesiyah Min HaShemayim. And that's a proof that this journey is not Min HaShemayim, because it didn't work out the way that we planned. The Chozu, and they went back. Chazar haben the limudo, and like many of the bachrim and many of the ingalai, is so good. They want to do the right thing, and he opened up his gemara, and he returned to his learning. But the shuv ra'a hafisar and shechosalam. But he's one of those big neshamas, like everybody here on this bus. He's one of those big neshamas of the end of time. And he couldn't help it, he just felt the chisar. Shechosalo ve'en yedeya. He didn't know why he felt this chisar. V'choza ve'hivtzir ba'oviv kanal, he went to beg his father again. And the father felt that he had no choice. V'huchrach l'nsoy imay shenis. And he felt that he had no choice, and he went again. Uchshenosu hemid oviv hanisoyin kibirishayna. But the father set up the test and insisted that the same test be used. Im yisnaheg keseda. Are things going to go keseda? V'nizdamein kishahoyu naisim. And v'nizdamein. No, it happened. Kishahoyu naisim, when they were traveling, v'nizbru shnei hayodais. The two axles broke. The tziri hamerkava, the oxen broke on the wagon. V'omle oviv, and the father said, re'ei she'en misnaig lonu l'nsoi. Don't you see that it's not misnaig lonu l'nsoi? That it's not going. Is this normal? Is this natural? That the two axles should break? Is this natural? Is this normal? Because remember, these chaykrim, these professors, they're very, very much meshubit to the world of teva and seichel. Is this normal? Is this derech ha-teva? She yishtabu shnei ha-aksel. V'kama pomim shenosu ha-merkova ha-zois, v'lo nizdamik ha-zois. So it sounds like it maybe even happened another few times. And they went and they returned, because it never ever seemed to go the right way. V'choza ha-ben anal l'darko kanal. And the son went back to learning. V'shuv hirgish ha-chasaron kanal. It didn't make a difference no matter how many times. He felt the chisar. The ha'anoshim yo'atsu oisai l'nsor. And he once again, each time, he went back to the chaver. And they told him, we have no other eitzah for you. It's not a matter of just switching your curriculum. It's not a matter of a different mesechta. They told him, you have to go to the tzaddik. The choza lo'ovi v'hivtso oisai kanal v'huchrach l'nsor yimo. But next slide. I mean, on top. And the father felt he had no choice, and they went again. But this time the son finally said, I will not agree to make our journey to the tzaddik dependent upon that test anymore. I'm finished. Because even by in your world of what's called derech ha-teva, sometimes a horse falls. Pushing the starbin ha axen, and sometimes the wagon breaks down. That's called derech ha-teva. But the son said, unless it's something which is murgash ma'oi, something which is very, very, very strange. Murgash ma'oi. V'nosu ubo lekretshma lolu. And they came. They were on the journey and they came to an inn to rest. Umotzu shom soicher. And they found over there was a soicher, a businessman. And remember that the boy's father was also a business person. And they began to have a discussion. The father, the Rav, who was obviously Isaac in these things as well, the Rav and his son did not tell these sachra, these business people, the purpose of their journey. Why? Because harav hayim is bayesh ba'atzma. Because the Rav was embarrassed. He was embarrassed to tell these Jews that he's going to a tzaddik, to that tzaddik. So they were talking about things of this world. They were talking, and in the conversation, it came up the subject of tzaddikim. Hechem nimtzoyim tzaddikim. where the tzaddikim live in that area. The Sipalem, Shasham Nimsa Tzaddik, Visham, and they were talking about how in that town there's this tzaddik, in the other town there's that tzaddik. And on their own, these two sachrim, these two guys, began to talk to the Rav and his son about the tzaddik that they were traveling to. The father, the Rav, said, Zeh? That person? He's a kal. He's a nobody. Who is he? So the Seichu is saying that Tzaddik, you're going there. He says, the Seichu, one of the Seichu said, I'm coming now from that Tzaddik. I was there by that so-called Tzaddik that you're going to, and I'm telling you, that tzaddik is Ishkan tzaddik, he's over Aveira. We saw ourselves that he was over Aveira. So now, Ono Ovi for Amalubno. So now the Rav says to his son, Hare Isa, Bini, my son, do you see? Mashizah Soichem Asapalafi Tumo. They themselves brought up the subject of the tzaddik, of that so-called tzaddik, and they themselves said that they were there, and he's not a tzaddik, he's an over Aveira, he's a Bal Aveira. So at this point, the son had no choice. This was a daven murgash ma'ay. The chozer lebeisim, and they went back to the house. Benifta Isa haben. But the son, the child, couldn't go on living this way, and he died. Because there's only so long that one can go without the light of the sun when you come from when you have one of these neshamas. Benifta Isa haben, and the son died. And he came in a dream to the Rav, to his father. And his father saw his son in the dream, that his son was very angry. And the father asked him in the dream, why are you so angry? And the son in the dream told his father, if you want to know why I'm angry, then complete that journey and go to the tzaddik that you never let me go to. Go to the tzaddik. Buhu yagin locha ama ani bekas. And the tzaddik will tell you why I'm angry. The heikits and the father, the Rav, woke up. For amar shemikrehu, as it is with such a person, the Rav said, it's dafke a Rav. In other words, Rabbi Nachman could have used a business person as the father, somebody else. But Davke, the one from whom we expect to find out the truth, a Rav. And the Rav said, Mikrahu. It's a coincidence. Mikrahu. Achakach cholm loy oid kanal. He dreamt the same dream again. Vamushu gam kein cholm shav. It's a stam cholm shav, an Irish guy. Kein ad shleisha pa'omim. But then he had the same dream a third time. The haven alay davahu. This is something already. Benosel l'sham, and he traveled to the tzaddik. Upoga b'haderech es asoiches shapoga mikoidem, and a very strange thing happened. He met the same business guy, the same merchant, the same soiches that he met last time. Beis shenose im benoy. When he went with his son, Vihikarei, he recognized him. For Amalai, he said to him, aren't you the guy, the soicha that I met last time in the kretchma, in the inn? Vaheshav, and he said, of course you saw him. Not Kay. Of course you saw him. Vivadai Re'isos. Upasach Pi for Amalai. And he opened his mouth, the Seichim, and he said, in Tirtzi, if you'd like to see, I can swallow you up, I can kill you. Omolai, the father, the Rav, said, Ma'ata Medaba, what are you talking about? Heishivlo, the Seichim said, Zocher Ato Kishanasate Ibincha, You remember when you traveled with your son? Ubatchila nofal sus, and this guy knows the whole story. Ubatchila, do you remember the first trip that you took? Nofal sus ala gesher, that the horse fell down by the bridge v'chazart, and you went back home. V'achakach nishbu ha'aksin, and then the second trip, the wagon broke. V'achakach, and then finally pogata bi, you met me at the kretchem at the inn. V'amati lucha shehu kal, and you remember I told you that the tzaddik is a nobody, he's a kal. And because I was able to bring about the death of your son, as bincha, achshav atar Yisrael, and so on, now you'll be able to go to the tzaddik. Obviously, this soichir is the sam himself, is the sam achmem, is the evil one himself. And now the evil one says to the Rav, to the father, achshav atar Yisrael, and so on, now you're permitted to go. Because you should know, you should know that your son was a big, big, big tzaddik. And he was the Mor HaKot. He was the small luminary. He was the moon. He's the Mor HaKot. But tzaddik hanal, and you should know that the tzaddik that he wanted you to go to, that he wanted you to take him to, but tzaddik hanal hu b'chinas Mor HaGod, is the tzaddik, the great luminary. He's the sun, the light of all worlds. And you should know that if the Mor HaKotan, if the small light, if the moon would have met the sun, would have been able to join together with the sun, because then it would have been and the light of the moon, which is Am Yisrael, would have been able to see the light of the Creator Himself, the Mor HaGadol. And it would have been, the light of the moon would have been restored to its beauty, to the light of the sun. And then Mashiach would have come. Because I was able to bring about his death, the death of your son. After Yisrael, and so on. Doesn't make a difference if you go. You could go now and look at the tzaddik all you like. Masach Dvarav, and while he was saying these words, suddenly, Ne'alam, he disappeared. The evil one disappeared. And the Rav was left standing there, and there was no one for him to speak to. And then the Rav came to the Tzaddik. Bitzok, and he began to scream, Chaval, Chaval, Chaval al da'avdin of Lemishdach. Chaval, Chaval, Chaval on that which is lost and will never ever be found. Can never ever be found. Hashem Yisbaruch Yoshiv Nidachena. Rabbi Nachman ended the story by saying, Hashem Yisbaruch Yoshiv Nidachena, that Hashem Yisbaruch bring us all back, all those who are lost, and all those who are dispersed, and all those who are a piece of the Mor HaKotan, that Hashem Yisbaruch should bring back all of those who are lost to the Mor HaGadol, to the great light, to the great luminary, to the Tzaddik. We should all be able to find our way to be able to return to the Tzaddik. Now we're going to discuss, I see Binyamin and Ushi, I see in front of me, there's still a couple of chevra that have their eyes open. So I hope that it's okay. And please, if you're tired and I'm bothering you from being able to rest, please, mechila. But we're going to talk about the inyan of the Tzaddik as the one who's able to bring back those who are lost. We're going to see that Torah in Yisrael and Uman. But I want to talk now for a few minutes about the Pe'er, the Tzaddik, the Great Light, who Rabbi Nachman called the Pe'er of the generation, the splendor, the light of the generation, Reb Levi Yitzchak Berditchev. Because we're going there, we're going to be arriving in the night. I told you a few minutes ago that the Kedushas Levi revealed the mystery, the sod, of Kfitzas Haderach. Now Kfitzas Haderach, you know, means that there were tzaddikim like the Baal Shem HaKadosh who were able to cross huge amounts of land, territory, oceans, and so on, miraculously, in small amount of time. The Koach of Kvitzis and Derech, the Chazal talk about, you know, from the Ovis, Yaakov Avinu, some other tzaddikim who had the Koach of Kvitzis and Derech. So let me share with you for a few minutes what Reb Levi Yitzchak Berditchev taught in regard to this side of Kvitzis and Derech. Reb Levi Yitzchak Berditchev would take many, many trips. You all know that he didn't really have a chassidus. Among the Talmidim of the Mezritcha Magid, we were hoping originally to be able to go to Anapoli to see the Mezritcha Magid, the Rebbe of Zushu, but that's not going to be this time. We may just have the next time. But you know that by the Mezritcha Magid, the Talmidim Mezritcha Magid, most of the Talmidim established courts. The Berditchev was one of the foremost Talmidim of the Mezritcha Magid. He himself did not establish a court, really. He did not have a chassidus. He was very, very often away. He was a derech. He always had a mysterious inyan that he was involved in. Sometimes he would travel hundreds of miles to go to meet one particular person, somebody who was not Shomer Mitzvahs or Russia. He would go to free prisoners, to pay ransom to free prisoners, to raise money for tzedakah and so on. He was involved in being mevatel gzeiros, all kinds of mysterious journeys. And we have many stories from those trips. And the Chassidim, of course, would always say that the Rebbe, the Kedushas Levi, was able to use the secret of Kvitzis Adair because it wasn't possible. The trips that he took, the places that he went, it wasn't possible for him to go and to come and to go the way that he was. So the Chassidim were always talking about how the Rebbe knew the soid, the mystery, and he had the shame of Kvitzis Adair. So one time, the Chassidim were having a conversation when the Rebbe came back, when the Kedushas Levi came back from a journey. The Chassidim were having a conversation, and one of the Zakenim, one of the older Chassidim, spoke up and he said, I heard from the Rebbe, from the Kedushas Levi, that a Chassid is a person who knows the Soid, the secret of Kvitzis Adar. And then the other Chassidim said to the old Chassid, Im Kain Ibazoi, then what kind of Chassidim are we? If the Rebbe said that a true Chassid knows the secret of Kvitzis Adar, then what kind of Chassidim are we? Because we don't know the shame, we don't know the name and the way, the secret of Kvitzis Adar. Suddenly, the Kedushas Levi himself came over there to where they were sitting, in the Beis HaMedrash. And obviously the Berditchev heard what they were talking about. And the Berditchev says, Kum Arayin, come over here to me, and I'm going to be Megala to you, I will teach you the side of Kvitzis Adar. Because in this Indian of Kvitzis Adar, there are two levels of side. There's Soid Shubasoid, there's the secret of secrets, that I'm not permitted to teach you. But there's also the Soid of Kvitzis Adar. There's the secret of Kvitzis Adar, and now I will teach you the Soid of Kvitzis Adar. So chevra, right now I'm going to share with you this, what I saw in a sefer, this Maisa, and I'm going to share with you the Soid, some of you might have seen this, the Soid of Kvitzis Adar, that the Berditchev taught to the Chassidim on that day. And he also taught that unless one knows the side of Kvitzis Adar, one is not truly a Chassid. And this, I'm going to read with you what it says in the Sefer. You don't have it in the Maariv Mekaymes. I'll read to you what it says in the Sefer. Yehudi Sheshari Chassid Sholem B'Yisur. If a Jew is, God forbid, in a state of Yisur, of suffering, of difficulty, kol tzad, every step that he takes, kol psiya ktana, every little step in his life, is doimelo ki'ilu oila al ha'gavoya mamish. When a person is, God forbid, going through some terrible tzar in his life, either physical tzar, or chas v'chalila, some emotional tzar, every tiny little step that he takes is like climbing a mountain mamish. Kol tzad koved, every step is so heavy. The gam imamer ha'kot, and even if it's only a little distance, but b'shviloi hu godlu ma'oid, but for this person who's suffering, it feels like it's mamish so far. And the gam hazman, and it feels like it takes so long. He says, kol rega mamish kishor, every minute, because his life is terrible, and he's suffering every minute, seems like an hour. Kol shor kayoyim, every hour feels like a day. Kol yoyim kechodesh mamish, and every day feels like a month. Masha'ina king, Reb Levi Yitzchak says, kishi Yehudi b'simcha, when a Jew is b'simcha, when a Jew is in a state of simcha. B'ahava, when a Jew is in love. V'yisa Yaakov rag love, as it says by Yaakov Avinu. How was Yaakov Avinu able, v'yisa Yaakov rag love, that he was able to know the secret of Tfitzeh Derech, to jump, to leap, to travel in such a way that his feet carried him in such a way. So Reb Levi Yitzchak says, "Bo'ovar harbe harbe zman etzalov and harosha." He worked for a long time, for many years. Yaakov Avinu worked for love and harosha. Bishvil Rachel Imenu, in order to be able to marry Rachel Imenu, because the moment he met Rachel, that love was revealed. That zivug, that was the deepest zivug. And really, so many years had to pass. But it says in Pasuk, "Vayiu be'enav kiyomim achodim," that for Yaakov Avinu was mamish like nothing. The time passed; it was like a few days, all of the years. Reb Levi Yitzchak said, "You know why? Because Yeshua's Hashem is keherif ayin. The salvation of Hashem is keherif ayin, is like the blink of an eye." Kasher Hashem is brought some in l'toyev al Yehudi. Keherif ayin means that when Hakadosh Baruch Hu turns to a Jew with love, and he places his eye upon a Jew, then hamokim v'hazman oivrim mamish, then the mokim, the space and time, moves very, very quickly, keherif ayin. It moves very quickly, like the blink of an eye. Doime doidi litzvi, like it says in Shir Hashir, that my beloved is like a gazelle that leaps and that jumps. L'oifer ha'ayolim, midalig elaharim, bekapitz elagvoz, that when you're in love, when you're besimcha, when Hashem is Baruch Hu reveals His love to you, Reb Levi Yitzchak says, then time moves, then there's a kvisas haderech, then everything in life is besimcha, and then you feel that everything is medalig elaharim, that you're leaping over mountains and you're jumping over hills and mekapitz elagvoz. Ha'simcha matzmicha knafayim al Yehud. Simcha, joy, causes wings to grow from a Jew. And he ended and he said the following. Bahavina. I just want to interrupt for a second before we finish the story, that all those who said tefillas haderech on the plane coming here, that this is still the derech that we're on. And you don't have to repeat tefillas haderech now. But for anybody who forgot to say tefillas haderech, you should say it now. Bahavina. You should understand. Kashi Yehudi Hoylech B'derech Ba'atzmai. Now, chevra, I'm talking to each and every one of you who is still awake. And even those of you who are not, and even those who might hear this some other place in time. Because we have in mind all the chevrim in Shul, and all the chevrim wherever they are. Reb Levi Yitzchak ended his talking to the chassidim, and he said the following. Havinu, he said, I want you to understand. Kashi Yehudi Hoylech B'derech Ba'atzmai. And God forbid a Jew is going in his life by himself when he's alone. Yechidi, kama aruchu haderech. He said, then the derech, the path, the journey, the way is so long. It seems so long, it's so hard when you travel by yourself. Avakashi Yehudim holchim biyachad. But with Jews who love each other like us, when Jews are holchim biyachad, when Jews go together with each other, it's a mamish mekatzir as a derech. It's mamish akvis as a derech, Reb Levi Yitzchak said. It's mekatzir as a derech. Madua, why? Ki ahava shruya b'nei. Because these chaverim love each other. U'medabrim zeh im zeh. and they speak to each other. U'mechayim zezeh, and they are mechaya, they give life to one another. V'chay achicha imach, your brother shall live with you. But Reb Levi Yitzchak says it means on a deeper level that one brother is able to give chayas, he's able to give chiyas to his brother. V'chay achicha, when? Imach, when you travel with another Jew together who loves you. V'chay achicha imach. V'oz, and then, kol Yehudi hu shnei Yehudim, shloish Yehudim, that every Jew is not one Jew, then he's two Jews, and more, and three, shloish Yehudim. V'kvar yesh harbe reglayim, v'harbe knafayim, and then there are already many legs and many wings. Ahava noiseis oisa mamish, and the love carries them along the journey, just like Yaakov Avinu was carried along all of the years because of his love for Rachel Imenu. And Reb Levi Yitzchak said, Zes soi kvitzas haderek. This is the secret, this is the mystery of kvitzas haderek. What's kvitzas haderek, Reb Levi Yitzchak said? Kvitzas hanefesh. Kvitzas haderek isn't some magic. It's kvitzas hanefesh, it's when the soul is leaping and jumping. Diglu alai ahava. That's the lesson that I taught, that the old chassid heard a little bit of, but he didn't understand. Eizuhu chassid. Who is truly a righteous Jew? Who is truly a chassid of the Baal Shem? Eizu chassid hayodeya sod kvitzas haderech. The one who knows the mystery of kvitzas haderech, of loving and being in love, of leaping, of jumping, of traveling on the journey towards the tzaddik, of not being overwhelmed or stopped by minias, by things that are in the way in life, even those things that come in the way of this, by way of the seichel, and by way of people who we respect, and so on. Be'emes, be'emes, Reb Levi Yitzchak said the last sentence, be'emes, be'emes. And the truth really, really is be'emes, be'emes. Zem maimer Rabbeinu HaBaal Shem Tov, didn't the Baal Shem Tov himself say, Eizuhu chassid, who is a chassid? A Mekayim, the one who is Mekayim, who fulfills the verse of Bechol Drachecha De'ehu. Bechol Drachecha De'ehu. Chosid Huzer Shanika Bedrachim. Bechol Drachecha De'ehu. In all of the paths of your life, De'ehu, you must know God. And a Chosid is a Chosid, and you can recognize a Chosid by how he conducts himself and how he feels when he's on the journey of life. When he's baderech, when you're on the way to the tzaddik, on the way, for many of us, the first time, for some of us, more than the first time, and each one of us had to go through certain minyas, but we're on the way, we're not so far away, and the time will pass quickly, because we're with each other. We're on our way to the pe'er, to the splendor of the world, to the Jew that Rav Kook called Neshama HaMerkazis, the central soul. Neshama HaMerkazis, the soul that is at the center of all existence. The Balabayas Al Kol HaOlam Kulo, the one who was Melitz Yaisha, the one who loved Jews more than anybody. The Reb Levi Yitzchak and Sarah Sasha. If we'll be Zoyche, we'll have time to talk more. At the Tzion, there's a Torah that we're going to, if we have time to learn a little bit, and then on the journey from there to Mezhmiz, we'll be able to learn a little bit more. I was already asked by a few of the chevra to explain a little bit the inyan of ishtadchus, of what is it that we're davening for, and how do we daven when we come to a tzion. And I will, Bez Hashem, it's hard for me to talk right now anymore, it's hard for you to listen, but Bez Hashem, Baderach, when we're traveling at a different point along the way, I'll spend 15-20 minutes or so going through a little bit the inyan in halacha, a little bit the inyan of ishtadchus from the Rashab. I've given some shiurim over the years in this inyan, but I'll try to give a very brief synopsis of what are the machshavas, what are the kavanas when we're at the grave of the tzaddik. I'll say now, because we're going to the Berditchev, that it's very, very clear that al pi the Zohar Kodesh, and the way the Zohar is understood by the tzaddikim, long tshuva from Minchas Elazar, from the Maran Shik and other tzaddikim, that one is allowed to speak directly to the tzaddik, and there's no isser of derish al hamesim. But one has to be careful that when you speak to the tzaddik, as it's printed in many of these old siddurim, in the Man Aloshin, and many of the old siddurim, that when you speak to the tzaddik, you could say, Rebbe, 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 and you could speak to the tzaddik. But remember, you're not speaking to his bones. You're not speaking to whatever remains of the guf. You're speaking to the nefesh, and you're begging the nefesh of the tzaddik to speak to the ruach and to the neshama of the tzaddik, and to return to and to enter into the highest place in Shemayim, and to bring the tefillahs to the highest place that's possible by way of Yerushalayim and Heaven, which we're going to be in a few days. So you can speak directly to the tzaddik, but remember, you're not speaking to chalila, to the guf of the tzaddik, but you're allowed to address the nefesh of the tzaddik. Even though there are those who disagree with that malach, but that's the consensus of the tzaddikim who went in the way of the mekubalim. The chidar writes, we have in the Shem HaGadolim from the chidar, that the chidar remembered that when he was a child, he went with the Aruch Chaim HaKadosh. I mentioned this, I was telling this to Mauricio before, that he went with the, that the chidar was zeichet to be with the Aruch Chaim HaKadosh by the kever of the pre-chadosh. And he was there when the Aruch Chaim HaKadosh spoke directly to the neshama of the pre-chadosh. And he was asking for mechila because the Aruch Chaim HaKadosh in a number of places in his farm disagreed with the pre-chadosh. And he spoke strongly. So he went to the pre-chadosh and he spoke directly to the pre-chadosh. But we're going to see that there are Makaris and Chazal, by the Tanoim, by the Maraim, and the Zohar Kodesh, and other places in Gemara, that one can speak directly to the Nefesh, the Ruach, and the Neshama, and that's the Inyan of Ishtachas by the Tzion of Tzadik. Hashem Yisbarach should help us that we should get there safely, and the journey should be one that will bring us closer to the true Tzadikim and closer to Hashem Yisbarach.
Record for most people. Most people are. Most people are.